Hello everyone, welcome to my channel again. My name is Morola K. Ajibola. I'm a registered nurse and a registered midwife. To my returning subscribers, I welcome you to my channel again. And if you are viewing me for the first time today, I welcome you to my channel as well. My channel is all about enlightening individuals, family, or public about some health condition, the how to prevent it or treat it appropriately in order to prevent any complication that can arise from it. And mostly I use my channel to talk about women's health. And today I'm going to talk about ectopic pregnancy. If it's something that you like to know more about, come along with me. Please don't go away. Let's dive into it together. Welcome back to my channel again. Today I'm going to talk about ectopic pregnancy. What is ectopic pregnancy? Ectopic pregnancy is implantation of fertilized egg outside the uterine cavity. Nature plays it in such a way that the uterus is the area of the female reproductive organs that allow and that can allow to expand, enlarge, to accommodate a growing baby. Any other place is not suitable for viability of the baby. Sometimes ectopic pregnancy can occur in the ovary, cervical region, or in the abdominal cavity, but most of the time it occurs in the fallopian tube. And what is now the causes of ectopic pregnancy? In some cases, there may not be any identifiable cause of an ectopic pregnancy. But what are now the predisposing factors that can predispose a woman to experience ectopic pregnancy? Number one is any previous history of ectopic pregnancy. If a woman has had an history of having an ectopic pregnancy, there is possibility of another ectopic pregnancy occurring. Another thing is previous abdominal surgery, previous pelvic surgery, pregnancy with the presence of IUCD, intrauterine contraceptive device, history of PID, pelvic inflammatory disease. What are the signs of ectopic pregnancy? Number one is pain. Abdominal pain that happens after a missed period. The pain can start from one side of the abdomen and diffuse all over the abdomen. Dizziness is another sign of ectopic pregnancy. If you are feeling dizzy in the first trimester of your pregnancy, it may be an indication for ectopic pregnancy, which you need to seek for health care. These are the earlier signs of ectopic pregnancy. But in case of ruptured ectopic pregnancy, the person affected may be having a shock and
there's going to be signs and symptoms that there is shock. The woman will be having severe abdominal pain, breathing rapidly, and we having all signs and symptoms of shock. So it's very essential to pick ectopic pregnancy at the earlier stage. How to diagnose ectopic pregnancy? Ectopic pregnancy can be diagnosed through transvaginal ultrasound scan, two blood tests for HCG, through the history given by the patients, and through the signs and symptoms shown by the patients.
What are the treatment options for ectopic pregnancy? The treatment depends on the stage of the pregnancy when it's been diagnosed, depend on the condition of the woman as well. So drugs can be used in the treatment of ectopic pregnancy if it's diagnosed on time. Drugs like methotrexate drug, which is used in the treatment of cancer, the doctor with their own discretion, the obstetric and gynecologist, will evaluate the systemic functioning of the woman, if the woman is suitable to be given this kind type of care. And it's more important for this woman to be a person that is going to comply with the treatment, because as the woman is taking the drug, they will be monitoring the blood test to ascertain that this is able to take care of the issue. If the woman will need any further treatment regimen, it can be, so that it can be provided if the woman is being monitored properly. Another treatment is now through surgery. It can be through laparoscopy, laparotomy, or sphincterectomy. Through laparoscopy, creating a small hole and remove the ectopic pregnancy, leaving the fallopian tube. It can be as a result of leaving of the portion of the fallopian tube that's been affected. It depends on the stage of the pregnancy and the condition of the woman. So, and these women experiencing this condition need all the care that they can get. They need counseling, they need support, their support system will support them, their healthcare provider must support them. Even after being discharged, they can go for therapy to make them recover from this experience. It's so important. I've come to the end of this video. Thank you for staying with me to the end. And until next time, I will be doing this another video. Take charge of your health. Bye.